Hey guys, you're watching Halborn Flash videos, and today we have got Bentzi from Utila joining us in for this chat. Welcome to this chat, Bentzi. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you joining us from?
Thanks, Arabdha. A pleasure to be here. I'm Bentzi. I'm based in, actually, it doesn't look like as people imagine, but it's Tel Aviv behind me. On the other end, you can see the beach and everything.
Beautiful.
I'm Israeli, born and raised. I'm coming from many years in the cybersecurity side from my IDF elite intelligence unit where I served many years. Actually, that's also where I met my co-founder, Sam, who is the CTO of the startup. After that, and after traveling to some places, and I think we'll also mention in the later this call, so I basically started working in the cyber industry here in Israel in security startups. I moved to the dark side, I would call it, for 2 years for the VC side. So I was leading pre-seed seed investments in Israel at deep tech companies. And around a year ago, I started my journey with Utila. Yeah, in my free time, I like to swim. I collect records. I like to travel when it's possible. Yeah, that's about me in a nutshell.
Wow, that's quite a journey from doing everything that you did in the past to Utila. So I'm sure there's a very interesting story there. So tell us a little bit more about how did you come about founding Utila?
Yeah, so maybe I can start with my, let's say, journey into the crypto world. It was, I think, back around 2016. Back then, I just started working in a company called Perception Point, which is a cybersecurity company in the email security side. Pretty boring area, to be honest. That was founded by a few friends of mine from the IDF, and used to be one of the first employees, and we used to sit in Tel Aviv in some tower. And back then, one of the days, I just came down from the office, and since I was a kid, I was playing chess. So I just saw a few people like playing chess there, and I just joined them. And then I found out that actually it was the Bitcoin embassy. I think since then, like, I started getting more and more like into the community, and they had some meetups and stuff. So it started actually by a chess game. Later on, like, I got my first Bitcoin and Ethereum and the white papers of Chainlink or any, you know, many other protocols. So slowly got into this world. And actually, the story of my co-founder Sam is pretty different. So Sam entered crypto from the academic side. He did like his second degree in the Hebrew University, and around the same year, more or less, there was also a course about Bitcoin, you know, mostly from the academic side, like game theory and all of that. And that actually, that was his point where he entered the world. So it was around the same time, very different directions. When we, you know, started to ideating like around what's next. So for us, it was sure that it will be in the intersections of two passions that we have, security and crypto. And I think that actually we haven't looked from the beginning specifically into like wallets or enterprise grade wallets. What we knew that we do something, we're gonna do for sure something around B2B, but and security, of course. But actually, the first thing that we looked at was mostly around transaction security, etc. So we started interviewing a lot of customers. Many of them were institutional investors, so like just teams involved in the crypto world. And again, actually, when we started asking them about their pain, so many of them returned to the wallet side. Like many of them just said, okay, first show me the wallet side, and then I want like you show me the transaction side. So I think for us, it was the point where we started looking more into the area of the wallets themselves. And when you think about wallets, a wallet is not just a place where it's not like a safe a lending a place, right? It's much more than that. Many times wallet is the gate or the access point into crypto. You don't necessarily just put an asset in the wallet and forget around it. Wallets are actually becoming more warm, more active, more connected. You do payment through wallets. You interact on-chain with wallets. You can interact with your friends in a way through wallets. So basically, Wallets are very different from what we imagine. And I think that as this world is evolving so fast, every time you also have a lot of new gaps created in the market and opportunities. I think that when we looked at the market back then, we realized that there are big gaps on the existing solutions. And as wallet is, you know, a massive layer in that, everyone needs wallet. For us, it looked like a huge opportunity that we want to solve, you know, mostly also to help onboarding the next billion people to crypto, to actually enable more institutional money flow into crypto, to enable more use cases.
Okay, that's quite a story from chess and game theory to crypto security and to wallets. And Utila is not just any other wallet. So tell us in a snapshot, what is Utila all about?
The idea of Utila basically is to create, I would say, accessible enterprise-grade wallets. The gap that we saw basically is that many teams, organizations today, they have like solutions like Ledger, Trezor, Gnosis Safe, MetaMask. And when they start to scale, they start to have like more complexities in, you know, managing multiple wallets, how you manage governance, how you make sure no one is running away with some of the wallets. Many of them are not connected well to multiple services. And this is from one end. On the other end, you can use like enterprise grade wallets, but many times they're pretty complex compared to the use cases you have. Okay, so the onboarding can take you a very long time. The day to day can be very manual and they can be very expensive. What we are trying to do is basically to take the security, I would say, of enterprise grade wallets and the connectivity that they bring to, you know, to the governance they bring, the multi-chain, connectivity to third parties like AML, exchanges, etc., but make them much more accessible and user-friendly. Like, to, let's say, when you look at the Web2 world, so you saw this shift, you know, from, let's say, the PayPals to the Stripes of the world. Auth0 was not the first authentication solution, but they came with this self-service approach, easiness, etc. And this is like the same thing that we are trying to create here. So we are basically trying to take something that works well and make it much more easy to use, easy to onboard. Today, you can onboard to us in 5 minutes. You can set your own governance. You can do things multi-chain. So on one end, you don't need anymore to use multiple wallets and then to understand how you do the governance. You can do all in one solution. And we also want to give this high security, high connectivity to third parties. So basically, to sum it up, maybe operational system for crypto might be the right word to use right now, but this is what we are trying to do. We have two types of offerings. So one is just for operations and treasury. So if you're like a CFO or operating in even a trading firm or family office, you can just set up a Utila wallet very easily. You can interact whatever you want. It can be Bitcoin, it can be a DeFi, it can be an exchange. You can set your own governance easily and basically do payments and do all of your operations through one platform. On the other end, you can be a developer that want to embed like some self-custodial wallets into your solution. So if you do something in payments, for example, or if you want to be a custodian and you need all the tech providing a layer for that. So this is like another offering that we have.
You're aiming at user friendliness, ease of use, faster onboarding, more security, just overall integration to better third-party solutions. How are you technically achieving this?
We have what's called one layer of the security side, which is the key management and the governance on top of that. When we talk about governance, we have two types of governance, internal for internal actions and external for every, let's say, transaction that is coming out of the wallet. And this is like one engine that we bought. This is like the basic, I would say. And we bought it in a way that we can connect it to multiple blockchains because we are using an MPC technology for the key management. This technology actually enables us to connect easily, I would say, to multiple blockchains, to multiple signatures, etc. So by using this kind of technology, we can be multi-chain very easily, whether it's like layer one, layer two, DeFi, etc. Another thing is just basically taking all of that and starting to connect it to accounting solutions, invoicing solutions, AML, compliance, off-ramps, on-ramps. We built the solution in a way that it's very pluggable, very easy to connect it to third parties. And this is like another aspect of the product. So there is the blockchain connectivity and there is the third-party connectivity. And when we started building the product, we already built it in from day zero, actually, not on a specific chain. We built it in a multiple chain. So the design and the architecture will be in a way that we can easily add more supports later on.
Fantastic. Yeah, connectivity is definitely something that's the next stage of progress. So really great to hear all of that. And where in the product roadmap is Utila right now? When is the launch coming up?
So now it's an exciting time for us. We just launched the website. And now actually in the product side, we are onboarding tens of customers to the platform. We are seeing just, I just finished a call an hour ago with one customer, and he just told me that now they manage all their funds in Utila. So that was like a great milestone to hear with them. So basically, we're having, you know, these first users of the product. We see a lot of transactions going through the system. We also get feedbacks, positive, negative, as a part of building the product. One of our main things that we do in the company is just to listen all the time to our customers, understand what they like more, what they hate, and build a product based on that. That's where we are today. Of course, in the next few months, the idea is to expand blockchain connectivity to add more blockchain support, to connect to more third parties, and to get more traction and trust in the market. I would say in the end, it's all about trust when you build a wallet. I do believe that the security and key management and everything is something that is important, and something that customers must feel comfortable with. But as time goes, it's much more about the experience that you need to create around it. So hopefully officially launch the company later this year.
Sounds like a great plan, looking forward. And we talked a lot of trust and security. So I have to ask you, what's your security strategy like, and why partner with a cybersecurity firm like Halborn?
For us, security is the most critical thing in our business. Whoever is choosing to use us in the end decide to move crypto money to Utila and to put the trust on our shoulders. In the other end, we've been, you know, in security for many years. You know, we feel very comfortable with building high scale security solutions. Everything that we do, we think about security, okay? And we think about the back end, we think about the human security, right? Like how we make sure that even if we do everything fine and we encrypt other things and we make it not so easy for any like potential attacker to get an access into the keys, etc. Also, we think a lot about the human side, you know, the human failures, how we make sure that no one in our customer side, even just this, you know, just doing a mistake and losing all the funds.
Right.
And on the other end, to make everything easy, accessible. So this is, I would say, some sort of the challenge on one end, but also the secret sauce of Utila is like getting these very high security measurements and, you know, think about security in every aspect on the product, but on the other end, to make it easy to use. Of course, a part of the security side of the company is, you know, we are very confident with what we do, but we need also third parties to make sure that we are not doing any mistakes. So we are happy to work together with with the Halborn, which is a company built of experts in the field. You know, I think I heard of Halborn even before I started Utila. I already met people who, you know, when I was just ideating around the security, they said, maybe you should look at the area of Halborn. Looks like this company is like exploding now. So I think that you guys did a really amazing job in the market. I think that for us, it's super important to work with the most expert, the biggest experts in the market when it comes to auditing. And we have the feeling that we know that Halborn is one of the best companies for auditing. On the other end, we do also work on, certifications, SOC 2. There is a new one for a custody that we are also looking at. So when we talk about trust, so trust is also about, third parties making sure auditing you, that you work on the right standards. So, and of course, it's also important who are those third parties. So for us, it was important to show that we are auditing by being audited by Halborn and hopefully getting their approval soon.
It's always great to hear, and we definitely appreciate the trust. I have to ask you, your journey has been quite something, building products and taking Utila thus far. So when you look back, do you have a takeaway that you want to share with us and the audience today?
The customer feedback is like the golden thing around it. You need all the time to talk to your customer to understand exactly what will make them use your product, understand exactly what is their pain that you are solving, understand how their day look like. For us, when we're like ideating, we just were sitting in offices of, potential customers and, just looking how they operate, how they work, how they talk to each other, what is missing, what works great. So you really all the time need to think about your customers. And it's not only when you are ideating, it's all the time. Like when you raise money, when you build a product, when you onboard customers, when you have a customer that is already like, using you, paying you money, how you make sure that, that they are happy with the product, how you make sure that you can upsell, how you make sure that you are covering all of their problems, and maybe there is a new problem that you haven't expected. So how do you make sure that you cover this problem as fast as possible? So I would say listening to your customers, asking the questions, try not to talk when you talk to them, just to listen, and basically then to decide with yourself if what you are building is actually the right solution. So I would say that's the main thing that I can say, and the main lesson that I learned through the way. Also for me, I think that I had this shift, okay? So you work as a VC before, and then you basically sit, people come to you, you ask them questions, and there you go home, you think about their answers, and then you basically decide, okay, we continue, we don't, but the work is very simple. You just sit and ask questions. And I think when I moved to the other side of the table and started to become an entrepreneur, so actually in the end of the day, I need to provide answers. Why I'm doing it? How can I make sure that what I'm doing is not something easy for other ones to do? What is my uniqueness? What makes our company special? Why we will be a unicorn? And it's not only answers to myself, it's also, of course, answers to my customers, to my employees, to my investors, to everyone. So I think for me, I needed to go through this shift from being like a question asking person to someone who actually need to provide the answers. And I think that the best way to be able to provide answers is actually to listen to your customers. We are super transparent. In our belief, everyone in a company needs to be a product person, and then let's say the backend developer. And that's the approach that we are trying to take in our company. So we are making everyone to speak to customers, to think with the customer. There is not only one person who is doing that. When everyone is doing something in the backend, in the front end, in the mobile, they all the time think about the customer side, and only then they think about the rest.
All right. So to sum it up, transparency in your culture, make everyone on your team think like a product person. Listen first, because that's often the most underestimated skill. And of course, always customer first. Those are great values to share. And thank you for sharing your journey thus far with us and for joining us for this chat. Looking forward to all the updates with Utila. Thank you again, Bentzi, for joining us today.